Good morning. Today 30th March, our second lecture, and now we'll be taking the new topic of rigid body, that is angular momentum. Like we have discussed it, that let's say, so first we'll go for give the heading, that is momentum of a rigid body, give this, and from there we'll come to know why we required a new physical quantity actually. Okay, so please give the momentum of a rigid body. First for pure rotation, first for pure translation. Okay, momentum of a rigid body in pure translation motion. So give the heading. Momentum of a rigid body in pure translational motion. So let's say we have a rigid body M1 moving with velocity V1, M2 V2, M3 V3, and somewhere we have a rigid body here, so there is a center of mass. So this is moving with velocity vcm. So if this is in pure pure translation, this rigid body is in pure translation, so we'll have here v1 equal to v2 equal to v3 and so on equal to vcm. Okay, so if I have to write momentum of this rigid body, that is just writing p, that is, so summation of, it will be summation of P1 plus P2 plus P3 and so on. So this again is summation of PI, okay, I from 1 to N. So this will be written as P1 will be M1 V1 plus P2 will be M2 V2 plus P3 will be M3 V3 and so on. Since it is in pure translation, so V1 equal to V2 equal to VCM, so this V1 vector V2 V3 can be written as VCM. So here this is M1, M2 up to MN into VCM. So that becomes total mass into VCM. So momentum of a rigid body in pure translation is MVCM. Okay, so momentum of a rigid body in pure translation will be this. Okay, so now after this, let's say now we'll go for momentum in pure rotation. So give that in next is momentum in pure rotation. So that is, let's say I have taken a rigid body, two dimensional rod I have taken just for to understand why we need a new physical quantity. So let's say this is hinged here, this is rotating with omega, then it is in pure rotation. So if it is in pure rotation, then what will happen? So omega for each point mass will be same. So if I write, let's say this is m1, this is m2, this is center of mass, so this is going to rotate, so this distance is, so its velocity will be v1 will be omega r1. This is rotating like this, this will be v2 will be omega r2, like this. Okay, so here if I want to write momentum of this rotating rigid body, So P of rigid body, since it's a pure rotation, and for us plane of rotational motion is fixed. So I'm taking a scalar quantum, I'm taking as a P only, because it's a 1D, it is going to rotate in this direction only. So at this moment P will be m1 v1 plus m2 v2, all will have this direction only. At this moment all will have this direction. So vector P is as good as P, and positive negative sign will be sufficient to explain the direction. So this P, if for pure rotation, will be m1, v1 is omega r1, m2 omega r2, and so on. So P here, if you just see, I can here write m1 r1 plus m2 r2, this is equal to omega. Omega is taken common, since this is in pure rotation. So after this, m1 r1 m2 r2 will be basically total mass into rcm into omega. So this is momentum of, so here we can also write m into omega into rcm becomes what? This is P is equal to omega into rcm becomes the momentum of, it's a velocity of center of mass, so m into vcm. So if pure rigid body is also rotating, then also you can write this one. If it is O1, this distance is R1, this is R2, like this. So this will be the momentum. Here also we are writing, if it is pure rotation, the total mass into velocity of center of mass is going to be the momentum of a rigid body in pure rotation. Now the next physical quantity which has been developed, like if any object is rotating, so one new physical quantity has been developed, and that is for translation also, that is known as angular momentum. This is momentum, pure momentum, now angular momentum. So give the heading, and how it will help us, we'll come to know. So next is angular momentum. This is written by L. L vector, L or vector, it's a vector quantity, L or L only, ठीक है? This is angular momentum, L. जैसे टॉर्क था, वैसे यहाँ पे एक न्यू फिजिकल क्वांटिटी विच वी हैव डेवलप्ड, दैट इज एंगुलर मोमेंटम. व्हाट इज दैट एक्चुअली? दिस इज डिफाइंड, इट्स अ न्यू फिजिकल क्वांटिटी. अगेन वी डेवलप अ फिजिकल क्वांटिटी डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द सिचुएशन विच हेल्प्स अस टू विजुलाइज द सिचुएशन इजिली, टू सॉल्व द सिचुएशन इजिली. सो दिस एंगुलर मोमेंटम इज डिफाइंड एज एल इज आर क्रॉस पी. This is R, vector R cross P vector. This is the angular momentum. Okay. Here, so moment of momentum is called angular momentum. So moment of momentum is called angular momentum. Here the vector R cross vector P is your, जैसे वहां पे था moment of force is torque, here moment of momentum, that's why we have done momentum at the starting. So moment of momentum is torque. तो ये R cross, if again R is the radius vector, about which we have to find the angular momentum. If I extend this, so again, first of all, it is a vector quantity, it is a its unit and dimension you write. So if you extend this, this r p sine theta n cap, okay. If I take here mod, so mod will be r p sine theta. This is p is what? So again, r sine theta, p becomes m into v. Let's say first we are doing for a point mass, okay, angular momentum for point mass, this one for point mass. So for point mass, momentum will be what? M into v, mass into velocity. So angular momentum will be written as r cross m into v, so that is r m v sin theta n cap. Okay, so if I just take modulus, r will be r sin theta mass into velocity, or m, or r m v sin theta, जैसे हम लोगों ने वहां पे किया था, जैसे हम लोगों ने टॉर्क के लिए किया था, तो वैसे हम लोग यहां पे कर रहे हैं. मान लो अ पार्टिकल इज मूविंग लाइक दिस, दिस इज m, दिस इज मास m, दिस इज द वेलोसिटी, एंड अबाउट दिस वी हैव टू फाइंड इट एंगुलर मोमेंटम. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल मुझे यहां से जिस पॉइंट के ऊपर निकालना है एंगुलर मोमेंटम, वहां से मैंने पहले r वेक्टर ड्रॉ किया. Okay, so this becomes my r vector, its mod will be r. So extend the line of action of force and drop the perpendicular, jo unhone us waqt bhi kiya. So here if you just see, sin theta will be angle between these two, this will be theta, so this is going to be 180 minus theta. Okay, so if I drop the perpendicular on the line of motion of the object, जैसे वहाँ पे line of force पे किया था, यहाँ पे line of motion, line of action किया, so this distance will be, you can see r sine of 180 minus theta, which is writing a d perpendicular, so it becomes r sine theta is d perpendicular. So here angular momentum will be r sine theta will be d perpendicular into m into v. This one. सेकेंड क्या हो जाएगा, एम वी साइन थीटा. अगेन यू कैन सी देयर विल बी विल हैव टू कंपोनेंट ऑफ वेलोसिटी, वन कॉस वन साइन. सो दिस विल बी, सो दिस इज परपेंडिकुलर टू आर वेक्टर, सो दिस इज वी साइन ऑफ 180 माइनस थीटा विच इज वी साइन थीटा. ओके, सो दिस और R M V perpendicular. Okay, और लास्ट में R M V sin theta either. तो यहाँ पे this equation we can use for finding the, जैसे हमने torque के लिए किया वैसे ही यहाँ पे हम इसके लिए कर रहे हैं कि extend the line of motion of force and drop the perpendicular. Okay. Extend the line of motion of force, drop the perpendicular, or take the component of velocity perpendicular to r vector. So whenever you have to find angular momentum, first where is origin, that you have to ask, and then you can find the angular momentum. So let's do a few questions here. Then, so right, the first question that is, find angular momentum of projectile. Find angular momentum of projectile of mass small m about point of projection. About point of projection. When projectile is at highest point when projectile is at highest point and when it lands on the same horizontal level. पॉज करके तुम लिख सकते हो. प्रोजेक्शन एंगल एंड स्पीड इज थीटा एंड स्मॉल यू रेस्पेक्टिवली. पॉज सॉल्व देन गो फॉर इट्स सॉल्यूशन. आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग विद द सॉल्यूशन. ओके सो हियर क्वेश्चन इज वी हैव अ प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन. दिस इज प्रोजेक्टेड विद U. So this is going to be the question. This is U theta. अपने को इसके about निकाल. So this is my origin. कहाँ कहाँ निकालना है? When it is at the highest point. At the highest point will have a just horizontal component of velocity. I think ये अभी बताने की जरूरत नहीं है. Horizontal component of velocity remains constant. And when it is going to land, it will be जिससे किया उसी से land होगा. And this will be theta. ऐसा रहेगा. So let's say we have to find, let's say 1 and 2. For these two we have to find. So angular momentum will be d perpendicular mv or r mv perpendicular. तो हमेशा पहले यहां से शुरू करो. ठीक है. So extend the line of action, line of velocity and drop the about O. So drop the perpendicular. So this becomes my, so this is what it is, maximum height h max. So for L1 it will be m u cos theta into h max is how much for projectile motion. It is u square sine square theta by 2g. Solve this, simplify this, that will be your answer. Second, about L2. About L2, you can see it's very easy to take component of U. This is V perpendicular, so U sine theta, and this is U cos theta. So this is my R for 2. This becomes my R. R is what? That is range. So here, angular momentum of 2 about O will be M U sine theta. I have taken perpendicular, I have taken this equation, this into R. R for this is range. Range means U square sine 2 theta by G. Solve this, simplify this, that will be your answer. Next question. A particle of mass M. Next question. A particle of mass M is traveling with constant velocity u. A particle of mass M is traveling with constant velocity u along line y equal to small d. Find its angular momentum about origin. And about x equal to d. When it crosses the y-axis, when it crosses the y-axis. So pause karo, solve karo. I am continuing. So draw the, so your y-x-axis they have mentioned. So it is moving along y equal to d. तो y equal to d line कौन सा हो जाएगा? तो this will be y equal to d line. So particle is moving along this. So particle is moving along this. This is with m u. तो अब about origin in the first case we have to find when it crosses the y axis, means जब वो यहाँ से cross कर रहा है. तो you can see here momentum is mu. So line of action पे drop the perpendicular, so this distance becomes d only. So about O, angular momentum is d into mu. Okay. Particle in fact कहीं भी हो, particle यहाँ पे भी हो तब भी its angular momentum will be this only, चाहे वो 0.1 पे हो 0.2 पे हो. So the same angular momentum will be for at 1, at 2. इस लाइन पे पार्टिकल कहीं भी होगा एंगुलर मोमेंटम इतना ही होगा. क्यों? बिकॉज द परपेंड एक्सटेंड द लाइन ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ लाइन ऑफ वेलोसिटी एंड ड्रॉप द परपेंडिकुलर, सो इट विल बी सेम. सो आइदर इट इज क्रॉसिंग वाई एक्सिस और इट इज एट 1 और इट इज एट 2, एंगुलर मोमेंटम विल बी सेम. नेक्स्ट इज, लेट्स से सेकंड वी हैव टू फाइंड अबाउट एक्स इक्वल टू डी. सो दिस इज माई ऑरिजिन, this is my origin. So about this we have to find. Now origin becomes this one, O2. So here also extend the line of action, line of velocity and drop the perpendicular. So it is going to be the same. So about O also it will be same. About O2, this is O1, about O2 also it will be same. Why? What we have to do? We have to extend the line of motion and drop the perpendicular from the given origin. So about this, about O2, which is x equal to d, it will be from here the perpendicular distance on the line of velocity will be same, which is d only. Next question. A particle of mass m is moving along line y equal to root 3 x plus 10. A particle of mass m is moving along line y equal to, it's a straight line, okay, with velocity u. Find its angular momentum about origin. Okay, so if I draw, so to draw a straight line we need two points. So when x is 0, y is 10, so this is 0, 10. When y is 0, x is minus 10 by root 3. If you join these two points, so you will have the equation. This is 0, 10. Okay. So particle is moving along this line. तो देखो particle is moving, particle कहीं भी हो, particle यहाँ भी हो, क्या अपने को, we have to find about origin O. So angular momentum वो क्या हो जाएगा? तो d perpendicular mv और r mv perpendicular. तो यहाँ पे which is easy, you take, तो now extend the line of action of line of velocity. So extended this and drop the perpendicular. So this is the, so perpendicular distance when for the straight line will be always fixed. This will be my perpendicular distance. So particle यहाँ पे हो, particle यहाँ पे हो, यहाँ पे हो, हमेशा this will be m v and this will be the distance d perpendicular. And for a straight line, how to find d perpendicular? So I think अगर formula याद होगा आपको, कोई भी स्ट्रेट लाइन है, लेट्स से स्ट्रेट लाइन का इक्वेशन ए एक्स प्लस बी वाई प्लस सी इक्वल टू जीरो है एंड परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस अपने को फाइंड करना है फ्रॉम एक्स वन वाई वन, फ्रॉम द पॉइंट डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम एक्स वन वाई वन. सो दैट इज डी परपेंडिकुलर इज पुट एक्स वन इंस्टेड ऑफ एक्स, पुट वाई वन इंस्टेड ऑफ वाई. तो एक्स वन, ये फॉर्मूला याद रखना है, बी वाई वन प्लस सी डिवाइडेड बाई स्क्वायर ऑफ कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्स. सो दैट इज ए स्क्वायर प्लस स्क्वायर ऑफ कोई बी इट्स स्क्वायर रूट, दिस बिकम्स द, ये हमेशा याद रखना है दिस फॉर्मूला. सो परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम अ पॉइंट टू अ स्ट्रेट लाइन विल बी ऑलवेज दिस. ओके, सो फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर इक्वेशन क्या आ जाएगा, दो परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस, डी परपेंडिकुलर विल बी x is 0, y we have to find from origin 0, 0. So x 0 is 10 by 3 plus 1, that is 4, 2, so that this is 5. So L naught becomes 5 m u. This is the answer. Okay, so this is what we have done, that is angular momentum of a point mass about given origin. Now next section is, what about system of mass or rigid body? So give the heading, angular momentum of system of particle. This we have not done in the previous classes, center of mass we have not done. So angular momentum of system of पार्टिकल. सो उसके लिए क्या करना है, अगर सिस्टम ऑफ पार्टिकल है तो वेक्टर एडिशन, फॉर ईच पॉइंट मास यू फाइंड द एंगुलर मोमेंटम अबाउट द गिवन ओरिजिन एंड ऐड देम वेक्टोरियली. सो दैट इज लाइक वी हैव डन सुपरपोजिशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फील्ड एंड इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, सेम हियर. लेट्स से वी हैव अ, again I am taking a system, it can be rigid body, it cannot be rigid body. Okay, so agar system of particle hai, bahut sare point masses hain, iske about apne ko find out, this is my origin. So what you do, this is m1 u1 m2 u2. So from here this is my R1, from here this is my R2 and so on, ऐसे ही किसी का भी आ जाएगा. तो ये net angular momentum will be L1 plus L2 and so on, that will be our net angular momentum, that is just superposition, we have to add them vectorially. तो यहाँ पे क्या आ जाएगा, so this if I write L1 will be R1 cross M V1, M1, let's say M1 U1 plus R2 cross M2 U2 and so on. So net angular momentum becomes summation R1 cross M1 U1, where let's say Ri, Mi, Ui, where I from 1 to N. So this is the superposition. Now angular momentum of a rigid body. Okay, now we are, this is for system of particle. Now angular momentum for rigid body, what it will be? So angular momentum for rigid body, again rigid body can translate, can rotate, can have both motion. So what we are doing, we always do pure translation. So give the heading, angular momentum of rigid body in pure translation. Angular momentum of rigid body in pure translation. This is going to be very important, okay, because this will be using in combined motion, okay. So angular momentum of rigid body in pure translation. So let's say, again फिर से वही figure में लूंगा, origin कहीं तो है, this is origin, this one is जो last लिया था figure वही, this one is R1, this is M1 U1, this is M2, this is U2 and so on. रेट बॉडी है, सिस्टम मास है, तो कहीं तो सेंटर ऑफ मास होगा. दिस इज आर सी एम, दिस इज यू सी एम, दिस इज नेट मास, टोटल मास ऑफ द सिस्टम. क्या होगा, सिंस दिस इज इन प्योर ट्रांसलेशन, तो कंडीशन क्या है फॉर प्योर ट्रांसलेशन, तो यू वन इक्वल टू यू टू इक्वल टू यू सी एम. सो एंगुलर मोमेंटम अबाउट ओ विल बी आर वन क्रॉस एम वन यू वन आर टू क्रॉस एम टू यू टू एंड सो ऑन. दिस इज एम वन इज स्केलर क्वांटिटी दैट कैन बी टेकन हियर एंड देयर. सो एम वन आर वन यू वन इक्वल टू यू टू इक्वल टू यू सी एम. सो दिस यू वन यू टू कैन बी टेकन एज कॉमन. सो एम वन आर वन एम टू आर टू सो ऑन दिस इक्वल टू यू सी एम. Put u1, u2, ucm, so that can take in common, cross will be also common, so this will be there. Ye kya hoga? m1, r1, so that is rcm, total mass into rcm into ucm, cross. This is position of center of mass into m ucm, so this becomes rcm cross momentum of center of mass in pure translation. So this will be the equation for pure translation. For pure translation, this will be the equation. Okay. So for if object, if rigid body is in pure translation, what we have to do? We have to just see where is the position of center of mass from the origin and what is its velocity. So RCM cross total mass into VCM is the angular momentum of rigid body in pure translation. Now what about in pure rotation? So let's go. That is the next one. So give the heading, angular momentum in pure rotation. And angular momentum in pure rotation is quite complicated. So angular momentum in pure rotation is quite complicated. I will take one simple case and we will make it generalized. We will write some important points because proof here won't be possible, and also in board also proof is not required. And if proof comes, so we will take a simple case only. Proof is not there at all, but if proof comes, you can take a simple case and you can prove this. For advanced batch, we'll be doing this proof, okay, live, okay, not recorded, live, means when we'll meet after this critical situation. So give the heading, angular momentum in pure rotation. So pure rotation, I have taken a rod. A simple, this is hinged here. This is rotating with angular velocity omega. Okay. So I have taken a special case because if I take a general shape of a rigid body, for that it is very complicated. That's why I'm not taking a general shape. I'm taking special case, special shape. For special shape, you can easily find, no problem. I am doing for rod, you can do it for ring, you can do it for disc. But for a general shape, what we will follow, we will write the points, okay. Here, so here it's a point mass 1, point mass 2, point mass 3, like this we have. Its velocity will be what? Again, this will have a different velocity, this will have a different, this will have a different velocity, because radius vector from the origin is different. This is going to execute this circle. This is going to execute this circle. This is going to execute this circle. So its velocity will be omega r1. Let's say this distance is r1. Its velocity will be omega r2. This is omega r3 and so on. Origin is this. So since it is in pure rotation, so pure rotation mein, so its perpendicular distance will be only r3, its will be r2, its will be r1, because velocity is perpendicular to the radius vector. So angular momentum in this case, since it is going to rotate like this, so you can see again, I forgot in last example the direction of angular momentum. So you can see जिस direction में momentum को rotate करो, जैसे if I take the questions again quickly, I forgot. सब में सिर्फ magnitude लिखा हम लोगों ने, ये origin है. First question अपने को it was a projectile motion. तो यहाँ देखो, it is going to rotate like this. It is clockwise. So the angular momentum का direction यहाँ पे inside हो जाएगा L direction. यहाँ पे इट इज गोइंग टू रोटेट लाइक दिस, तो यहाँ भी इनसाइड होगा. सिमिलरली द सेम वे एज वी हैव डन फॉर टॉर्क, ओके, यू कैन सेम वे यू कैन फाइंड द डायरेक्शन, इट्स अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी. द हियर आल्सो द एंगुलर मोमेंटम ऑफ पॉइंट वन विल बी अबाउट, सिंस ऑरिजिन इज दिस, सो इट इज गोइंग टू रोटेट लाइक दिस, इट इज गोइंग टू रोटेट लाइक दिस. ऑल आर गोइंग टू रोटेट इन द सेम डायरेक्शन. इफ देयर इन सेम डायरेक्शन, सो वी कैन एड देम स्केलरली आल्सो. सो इट विल बी, so L, since direction is fixed, so L will be m1, let's say r1 into m omega r1. This is m into v, m1 into v, r2 into m2 omega r2, and so on. This is my L. So L becomes here, if you see, omega is common to all, so m1 r1 square plus m2 r2 square and so on, this is equal to omega. So L becomes what? This is nothing but it is moment of inertia I into omega. Here L we have found about this axis. So here, so L is equal to I into omega. L equal to I into omega. So this is, I have taken a special shape, but this is going to be valid for all other shapes or remaining shapes, but with some caution we have to use this equation. So L is equal to I omega for pure rotation is the net angular momentum. So please write few points here, very important. Proof we'll be doing for advance, okay, when we'll meet live, okay. First point, important points, please write it. For collection of point mass, for collection of point mass, total angular momentum is summation of individual angular momentum. For collection of point mass, total angular momentum is summation of individual angular momentum in vector form. Direction should be also there. So please, बाकी सारे जो क्वेश्चन उसमें सब में direction fix करो, ठीक है? ठीक है? Second point, for rigid body, for rigid body, L along given axis is equal to I along that axis into omega. For a rigid body, L about a given axis, जैसे for this rod axis was this, so we have found angular momentum about this axis. So angular momentum about this axis is equal to moment of inertia about this axis into omega. Continue here. उसी में here L axis doesn't mean, here L axis doesn't mean total angular momentum of rigid body. Here L axis doesn't mean total angular momentum of rigid body. Rather, it means, very important, it means, this L axis means component of angular momentum component of angular momentum along the axis. Component of angular momentum along the axis. Okay, दोनों में difference क्या है? काफी difference है. उसपे हम लोग आते हैं. Next point लिखो. If rigid body is symmetrical about the given axis, then L total will be along the axis itself. Then we can write I along axis into omega. So agar symmetrical rigid body ho, tabhi total angular momentum will be I axis into omega. Means total angular momentum will be along the axis. But if rigid body is not symmetrical about the given axis, then component of angular momentum along the axis will be taken. And that is equal to I axis into omega. Not symmetrical. Then L along the axis is equal to I axis into omega. ठीक है? ये कैसे हो गया? तो इसके लिए जब हम लोग ये करेंगे, तो यहाँ पे देखो, actually ये मैंने statements क्यों लिख के दिए? क्योंकि इसपे theoretical questions आते हैं, objective में theoretical questions आते हैं इसमें कि that is L total angular momentum may or may not be equal to total angular momentum. Next point मैं उसी को बार बार लिखवा रहा हूं. Total angular momentum may or may not be equal to angular momentum about the given axis. When it will be equal? When it is a symmetrical rigid body. Like the rod which I have taken, this is symmetrical rigid body. If it is not a symmetrical rigid body, then L total angular momentum will not be equal to angular momentum along the axis. And angular momentum for a rigid body is L I axis into omega. Means जिस एक्सिस के अबाउट हम लोगों ने टोटल एंगुलर मोमेंटम लिखा है उसके उस एक्सिस के अबाउट ही आई एक्सिस अपने को निकालना है. अगर किसी ने लिखा कि लेट्स से एल इक्वल टू आई ओमेगा, दिस मे बी रॉन्ग, दिस मे बी करेक्ट. ये कब होगा सही? दिस विल बी करेक्ट व्हेन रिजिड बॉडी इज सिमेट्रिकल अबाउट given axis. But if L will not be equal to I axis, if rigid body is unsymmetrical, then we have to take component of L along the axis. So that L along the axis will be I axis into omega. यहाँ पे मैं लिख देता हूँ I axis. Okay. अगर rigid body symmetrical नहीं है, unsymmetrical है, then we have to take component of rigid body along the axis, and that will be equal to I axis into omega. For pure rotation we are doing. फिर इतना confusion है, फिर क्या करेंगे हम लोग? तो जैसे भी कैसे, मतलब कौन सा symmetrical है, तो जैसे भी ऐसे ring हो गया, disc हो गया, है ना? Like अभी जो rod किया हम लोगों ने, rod में देखो, rod में after some time it is going to be like this. तो you can see it, this axis यहाँ से यहाँ means जितना mass इधर है उतना ही mass इधर है. So what does the meaning of symmetrical object? So please write. If a body is symmetrical about the axis of rotation, means body is symmetrical about the axis of rotation, means that for every mass element in the body, means that for every mass element in the body, there must be an identical mass element diametrically opposite to the first element and at the same distance from the axis of rotation. The same distance from axis of rotation. जैसे भी यहाँ पे ये rod जब rotate हो रहा है, तो मैं इस mass को नहीं देखा, axis of rotation ये है. तो यहां से जब वो रोटेट होके यहां पे आएगा, तो फिर यहां पे भी ये जितना डिस्टेंस वहां उतना ही डिस्टेंस यहां पे, तो डायमेट्रिकली अपोजिट वो उतना ही मास होना चाहिए अगर वो रोटेट भी हो रहा है तो. ठीक है, मतलब लेट्स से इफ आई, अगर यहां पे अगर कोई ये भी बोल सकता है कि ये रॉड है, रॉड के मैंने कि रॉड को अगर तुमने, रॉड को तुमने बीच से किया, यहां से तुमने हिंज किया, तो दिस इज माई एक्सिस, तो यहां से जितना दूर मास एलिमेंट उसके डायमेट्रिकली अपोजिट वहीं पे उतना मास आना चाहिए, देन दिस रॉड इज सिमेट्रिकल अबाउट दिस. ओके, यहां पे ये रॉड मैंने यहां से हिंज किया है, तो ये तो सारा मास इधर, इधर तो कुछ मास है ही नहीं, तो सिंस दिस इज अ 2D ऑब्जेक्ट, सो 2D ऑब्जेक्ट आर गोइंग टू बी सिमेट्रिकल, नो प्रॉब्लम इन दैट. 2D ऑब्जेक्ट के लिए एंगुलर मोमेंटम का कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं आएगा, बिकॉज रोटेट होके फिर वो मास यहां पे आ जाएगा, तो ये दोनों डायमेट्रिकली अपोजिट हम लोग बोल सकते हैं कि मैंने एक रॉड को बीच से कट कर दिया, हम लोग यहां पे ऐसा अज्यूम कर सकते हैं. लेकिन वही अगर तुमने ये ले लिया, जस्ट अज्यूम करो कि ये एक्सिस है, ठीक है, और ये रॉड है, ठीक है, ये ब्लैक वन इज माई रॉड, दिस इज एक्स, और इसको मैं रोटेट कर रहा हूं, वी आर मेकिंग अ कोन हियर, वी आर मेकिंग अ कोन हियर. ठीक है, तो वी आर मेकिंग अ कोन हियर, सिंस नाउ दिस कोन इज अ 3D ऑब्जेक्ट, सो नाउ दिस वॉन्ट बी सिमेट्रिकल. 2D ऑब्जेक्ट है तो उस केस में कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं आएगा, यू कैन ब्लाइंडली राइट L एक्सिस, L इक्वल टू आई ओमेगा फॉर 2D ऑब्जेक्ट इफ रोटेशन इज इन 2D. बट हियर इट इज गोइंग टू डिस्क्राइब अ कोन, कोन इज अ 3D. 3D में आते ही वी हैव टू बी केयरफुल, उस केस में L एक्सिस वी हैव टू टेक. सो वट एवर क्वेश्चन वी आर गोइंग टू गेट, दैट विल बी 2D ओनली, सो देयर वी वॉन्ट हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम, वी विल बी इन सेफर हैंड इफ वी यूज ब्लाइंडली आई, L इक्वल टू आई ओमेगा, दैट वॉन्ट हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम, दैट वॉन्ट गिव एनी रॉन्ग आंसर. बट हियर, सो हियर ऑल्सो द सेम थिंग, दिस रॉड इज गोइंग टू रोटेट इन 2D, सो हियर I axis, L total is I axis, L is equal to I omega. It won't be a problem. But वही अगर मैंने जो अभी दिखाया, ये axis है और ये rod है. If this rod is going to rotate about this axis, so it is going to execute a cone. Then this will, so in this case, you can see, इसके डायमेट्रिकली अपोजिट कोई मास नहीं है। कोई यहाँ पे ये भी बोल सकता है कि सर घूम के तो आएगा, घूम के आएगा वो 2D ऑब्जेक्ट में ही, 3D में नहीं। एक्चुअली अगर तुम इसको देखो तो ये भी अनसिमेट्रिकल है, मीन्स अगर रॉड के एक एंड से मैंने अगर एक्सिस मैंने यहाँ पे हिंज किया है तो इट इज अनसिमेट्रिकल, बट सिंस इट्स अ 2D सो इन 2D में देयर विल बी नो प्रॉब्लम। 2D में वी कैन से लूजली, वी कैन से लूजली दैट दिस इज सिमेट्रिकल, बट एक्चुअली इट इज नॉट सिमेट्रिकल। बट इन 3D दिस वॉन्ट बी अ प्रॉब्लम, जो जो मास यहाँ पे उसके डायमेट्रिकली अपोजिट कोई मास नहीं है, उस केस में विल हैव टू टेक एल एक्सिस कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ एंगुलर मोमेंटम अलोंग द एक्सिस दैट विल इक्वल टू आई एक्सिस इनटू ओमेगा। अपना जितने भी ऑब्जेक्ट हैं दे आर लाइक रिंग है, रिंग इज सिमेट्रिकल, डिस्क इज सिमेट्रिकल, सो वी वॉन्ट हैव अ प्रॉब्लम, बट फॉर थियोरेटिकल क्वेश्चन दिस हैज टू बी देयर। When we'll be meeting for advance, there will prove in this case what will be the angular momentum. When rod is rotating with omega, axis is this, this is axis and rod is rotating like this. Okay. So for 2D object, if it is not symmetrical also and object is executing a 2D motion, then you can blindly write L equal to I omega. That won't be a problem. But for 3D, we have a problem. ओके जैसे भी मान लो इसी क्वेश्चन में अगर मैं ये ले लूं, ये एक्सिस है ओरिजिन यहाँ पे और मैंने एक मास यहाँ पे, ये रॉड है, रॉड इज मासलेस, एक मास यहाँ पे, तो यहाँ से जितना दूर ये मास है उतना ही दूर यहाँ पे मास है, सो नाउ दिस इज सिमेट्रिकल एंड ओरिजिन इज हियर, सो इस केस में दिस इज गोइंग टू एग्जीक्यूट अगेन cone will be executed. For this mass we can write L total is I into omega, I along the axis into, or you can just I omega, I will be along the axis, axis is this only, so this is symmetrical because jitna mass yahan pe diametrically opposite mass hai, matlab ek massless liya hai rod, theek hai, yahan pe ek mass attach kiya hai and origin yahan pe liya hai, to iske about to axis yahan se ho raha hai pass, to axis is passing like this, origin yahan pe, it is going to rotate, so this will be symmetrical. So we'll continue this, think on it, any doubt tomorrow ask. I'm just stopping for that only, and that's all for the day. Be safe, be at home, study well, meditate well as much as you can, and let's meet tomorrow 7:20 for doubts. For first, we'll be doing chemistry again. The remaining question, then we'll go for physics. Thanks a lot. Keep watching Maestro Academy channel.